In the last class, we were discussed about the plant reproduction. Once again, we will brush up plant reproduction. Plant means, as you know that plant is a living being which contains roots, leaves, flowers, etc. Reproduction means producing young ones. And the reproduction takes place with the help of the seed. And when we see, when the seed is sown in the soil contains NPK. NPK value, that's the nutrition. And N stands for nitrogen, P stands for phosphorus, K stands for potassium. Next, coming to the next concept, yesterday we discussed seed germination. Seed germination, in Kannada we call it as molake barubudu. Molake, seed germination. Seed germination, for that purpose we need oxygen, water, and warm condition. So oxygen, in the air we will get oxygen, water, we need to add the water, and warm means sunlight, photosynthesis process, I mean to say it's a photosynthesis process. So these aspects like oxygen, water, and warm, when it will get a sufficiently, the seed will start to germinate. So up to last class we discussed these kind of aspects. Next, today's concept is dispersal of the seed. Seed dispersal. See, seed dispersal means what? Just, okay. I want to show. Okay. Consider these are the seeds. Seeds dispersal. Dispersal means what? Moving some other places moving. So dispersal of the seeds means scattering the seeds away from the parent plant. Consider this as a parent plant, and when the seed gets, due to the wind, due to the water, the seed gets dispersed. The seed get dispersed. So this is what the dispersal of the seeds. Definition of the dispersal of the seeds is scattering the seeds away from the parent plant is called as a dispersal of seeds. Next, there are so many types of dispersal of seeds. Is that according to your syllabus? First is wind dispersal. First is wind dispersal. Wind blowing the air. When the air will blows, the seed get dispersed. How? Very simple. The hairs of the seeds. What makes the seed disperse? Once again, I will repeat. What makes the seed disperse into the air? 1 mark question or 2 marks question. Give the reason. What makes the seed get dispersed into the air? And your answer, the hairs. Hairs like this. The hairs of seeds or wings. The hairs of seeds and wings helps them float in air. This wind dispersal, the hairs of the seeds or wings help them float in the air. And example is dandelion. This dandelion is a type of seed which is very available in the America, in the South Africa and America. In these countries, the dandelion is available. In India also we get, but most of all these seeds are available in the South African countries or American countries. So dandelion, and here is a dandelion seed. Here is a dandelion seed, and dandelion seed, these in outer layer seed, it has a hairs. It has a hairs like this. These are the hairs, dandelion. And this is the seed, and it is an example for the wind dispersal.
hairs. Due to the hairs, seed get dispersed easily in the wind. Easily in the wind. Example is dandelion. Next, water dispersal. See, water. I have written H2O. H2O is a water formula. WATER. Instead of writing WATER, I have written H2O. H2O means water. It's a formula for water. Water dispersal. Water dispersal. And example is a coconut and lotus. Coconut and lotus. Coconut. Coconut particular thing in my vita. It has a husk. Naru kettivi. Tengirkai mane idaga nodi aa naru kettivi. It is very tight. Fibrous husk anta irutte. So due to the husk water dispersal, I mean coconut is the perfect example for this water dispersal. Due to the fibrous husk, coconut will easily flows into the water and move from one region to another region. And also, as well as the lotus also, L-O-T-U-S, lotus. Lotus is also having the petals. Due to the petals, it will easily flow on water from one to another place. So this is water, wind dispersal and water dispersal. Next, animal dispersal, animal. When we see the bushes area, when the animal go inside to hunt, to catch the prey, some seeds will stick on their hairs of the body. Once again I will repeat, animal dispersal. With the help of the animal, the seed get dispersed. Just you imagine. What you want to imagine is some bushy areas. Suppose when a wolf or a tiger or anything else, when the animal get inside into the bushy area to catch the prey, those seeds are stick on their bodies. After that, the animal will not only live in the same place, it will move from one place to another. When the animal gets irritated, the body will shake like this. It will shake like this. So the seeds will disperse. So this is called as an animal dispersal. This is called as animal dispersal. So, in today's class, we discussed about the seed, dispersal of seeds. Once again, I will repeat, dispersal of seeds, scattering of the seeds away from the parent plant is called seed dispersal. Types of seed dispersal, one is a wind dispersal, example is a dandelion. Dandelion is having a fine hair-like structures. Due to that, it will easily float on the air and hence the it will get dispersed. Second is water dispersal. Example is coconut and lotus. Coconut has a fibrous husk, makes coconut to easily flow on the water. And third one is animal dispersal. Animal dispersal, when the animal get enters into the bushy areas. To catch the prey, though some seeds are get attached to the bodies and hence it get dispersed. In that way, it will be dispersed. Okay? Thank you, Ananda. In the next class, we will discuss about some other aspects. Thank you, Ananda.